Welcome back. We continue to follow breaking news tragedy just outside the Empire State Building. Here's what we know. 11 people have been shot. Two are dead. Now, here's what we know. A gunman, a person by the name of Jeffrey Johnson, I believe in his mid-50s, was disgruntled, was laid off from the Zahn company. This is a place Zahn imports. Basically, they make women's apparel. And he was laid off just about a year ago. So a year later, he comes back today and is targeting a coworker. There's a word that there was a claims of harassment between the two, some kind of a long feud between the two. And again, the gunman shoots and kills a coworker, shot and killed. And then the gunman, again, Jeffrey Johnson, tried to get away. But a construction worker followed this person, alerted police, and then police exchanged gunfire. They shoot and kill Jeffrey Johnson in the midst of all the gunfire. 9 people were wounded. Thankfully, they're going to be okay. Joining us now, Steve Cardigan, former police detective. Steve's been with us off and on throughout the morning as we've continued to follow this. Steve, did you suspect this, that something like this, because you and I were wondering motive, what could lead to all this, and we're finding out someone laid off a year ago, and they come back and do something like this, and tragedy unfolds.
Yeah, Mike, and speaking with you this morning, it was certainly a high consideration. And, you know, we look at workplace violence. The Department of Labor reports that 2 million Americans are victims of workplace violence, and this being the ultimate horrible act.
Steve, as we take a breath and we look at a situation like this, let's talk about how it unfolded. So this person, this was not just someone shooting. This was a person who targeted the person that ended up being shot and killed. And we knew that. They had Jeffrey Johnson had a .45 caliber, shot and killed someone, tried to get away. But it was a construction worker who followed and noted police. You know, if you see something, say something. That's been the motto there in New York City. And this construction worker did a great job.
Yes, he did, Mike. And that is the motto. And if more people would engage in that behavior, I think the city would be even safer than it is. And it is one of the most safe cities in the United States. But he did a good job in reporting to police. This man was on a mission, a fatal mission, and he happened to run into police en route to his escape. So thank God that it happened this way and more people were not injured.
Okay. You know, and we heard from New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg clearing up and answering some of our questions for us and saying that in the exchange of gunfire between police and the gunman, you know, there could have been some of the people getting shot. Again, we know 9 wounded. They're going to be okay, thankfully. But that can happen. Right, Steve?
It certainly can. I mean, the slightest movement, if he's struck, if he's falling, if he's moving, if he's dodging, those bullets go on a straight path towards their intended target. And often, you know, we see multiple shots being fired in a gunfight, and that's one of the reasons. It's hard to hit a moving target.
Hey, Steve, where does the investigation go from here? Obviously, you've got evidence with the crime scene, but yet we also have a ton of questions, I'm sure authorities will as well, as to what led to this. Someone basically stewing over this for over a year and the backstory that could have led to this tragedy.
Yeah, complaints and cross complaints at the workplace. What law enforcement's going to do, and I understand through my contacts at NYPD, they're executing a search warrant at his home right now to obtain his computer, and the ATF is also present to check on any weapons that may still be stored in his apartment.
All right, and again, the challenge for authorities, reiterate for that for us, when you're talking about, I mean, this is a high traffic area. We're talking about one of the great tourist attractions in the country, right in front of the Empire State Building, and people gathered around, they want answers. How do you keep people calm and keep people safe in the midst of something like this?
Well, what law enforcement does is they respond in the masses with EMS, they cordon off the area, they try and identify witnesses, and they secure that area slowly, taking it over block by block, moving the people back in a safe and orderly manner so that they can conduct their investigation in a thorough and prompt way.
All right. Hey, Steve, thanks again. We're going to continue to follow this for you throughout the day. If you've got so many questions, we thank Steve, our law enforcement analyst, Mike Brooks, as well, as we're digging for those answers. Why would something happen like this? We know at the end of the day, 2 people dead, including the gunman, 9 wounded. Thankfully, those 9 wounded are going to be okay. We're going to keep you updated on that and also an incredible chase in the Florida area. We'll get you some more answers on that as well. Quite a news day. Stay with us. You're watching HLN.